going to jump on the accelerator early, and we are going to see the green flag. So Pedro Hita jumps to the advantage. Santi Urrutia runs second. They'll go side by side for the third spot. Points leader Kyle Kaiser on the outside. Nico Jamin on the inside.
Kaiser gets a great run down the banking at the exit of turn number two. He'll grab that third spot. Meanwhile, Urrutia tries to set up Pedro Hita. He's right in his tire tracks. Runs a half a groove higher now through three and four.
Here come the leaders out of turn number four. Santi Urrutia now gets right in the draft of Juan Pedro Hita down the front straightaway, and we've got a yellow flag. One car is around exiting turn number four. It's going to be a three or four car accident. We see two Ballardi Auto Racing cars involved. That was Shelby Blackstock and the nine of Aaron Tielitz. We also see the 22 of Neil Albarico, who was slowed on the racetrack. David, we see some rear wing damage to that nine of Aaron Tielitz as he has come to a stop at the inside of turns three and four.
Yeah, he definitely lost the left side end fence to the rear wing. Can't tell if there's damage to the left here. He's pulling away, pulling into the pits. We'll see what happens right now. We see, just a Blackstock, the 51 car, just gets loose. His teammate just had nowhere to go. He gets sideways, gets into him. Wow, amazingly, I think the 9 car may be done, but I think the 51 car could continue on, and it was just trying to avoid him.
Rob Howden is on pit lane and joins us for this race. Rob, a lot of drivers getting sideways. Actually, we saw two separate incidents as Neil Albarico spun all by himself as well. A lot of those cars involved in that accident brought those machines to pit lane.
Yeah, right here, right now with Shelby Blackstock and Aaron Tielitz. To give you an update on damage, it's a flat left rear for Shelby Blackstock. They're putting a new tire on. They're already going to get rolling already. Moving down here to Aaron Tielitz, though, major damage to the rear wing. The whole end plate's off. Really make contact on the rear attenuator of that car as well. So someone potentially backed it into the wall as well. But again, they're going to work here, Nick Yeoman, to see if they can't get Tielitz back onto the racetrack. But wing damage, number one for that race car.
Davey, what's to tell you about these race cars or the racetrack? The fact that we saw two different drivers get sideways there in three and four.
Well, I think the problem is on this particular racetrack, I think we should have went with a couple warm-up laps. We just did one tie by and came to green. I don't think that was enough time to get heat into these tires in this particular racetrack just because it's so hard to do. So I kind of blame that on maybe not enough, heat in these tires because they didn't have a lot of speed going down there in the cars. Just you see them, how much lack of grip there is right now with them sliding around. So unfortunately, it is what it is, but I have to think that was part of the issue.
Boy, a lot of rear wing damage to that nine of Aaron Tielitz, and just got a good shot of the front wing of the 22 of Neil Albarico. It looks like he has damage to that front.